And on the foreign scene, Japanese government says at least 10 people have been killed and about 300 injured by Typhoon Jebi, the worst storm to hit Japan in 25 years. Jebi left a trail of destruction across the west of the country, hitting major cities like Kyoto and Osaka. Flights, trains and ferries were cancelled, but thousands of passengers stranded at Osaka's international airport have since been evacuated as the wind slows down and moves north. People are urged to stay alert for landslides and floods. And U.S. President Donald Trump has once again blasted CNN and NBC's news yet again in a tweet on Tuesday, criticizing NBC's handling of a story on movie producer Harvey Weinstein and suggesting a look at their license without specifying what exactly he was calling for. President Trump has frequently criticized the U.S. news media for what he has said is unfair coverage of him. Comcast Corp., which owns NBC News, declined to comment. Following the tweet, a decline in the price of Comcast shares on the NASDAQ extended slightly. The U.S. Federal Communications Commission did not immediately comment on the tweet, but in October, the FCC's chairman said the agency does not have authority to revoke broadcast licenses over editorial decisions. And in South Korea, envoys held talks in North Korea on Wednesday to finalize details on a third North-South summit to be held this month. Amid stalled talks on denuclearization between the North and United States, South Korean officials hope that a one-day visit will revive momentum after a broad but unspecific agreement on denuclearization between the United States and North Korea at a Singapore summit in June. Those talks have stalled since U.S. President Donald Trump canceled Secretary of State Mike Pompeo's trip to North Korea last month. It's now time to talk business with Edith Young as she brings us the latest updates.